Awesome. Something that I want to jump off of now, we're talking about Jesus. People will say, hey, wasn't Jesus tempted? The Bible says he was tempted like we were and did not sin. Does that mean that Jesus was tempted with homosexuality, same-sex attraction, and lust for others? But hey, he didn't act on it. I know you've talked a little bit about same-sex attraction and lust and Owen, the tension that's in the heart, and because our hearts are sinful. But hey, Jesus's heart wasn't sinful. He was not depraved like us. There was no little small, molecular size corner of sin where he had just a little one that's so insignificant it would matter. Jesus was tempted just like us. Was he tempted towards homosexuality and same-sex attraction?
Yeah, there's a lot of discussion about this today, Kosti. A lot of people are asking this question. When I teach on Christology at the MDiv and the PhD level here at Midwestern Seminary in Kansas City, the first thing I say before we even dive into any of the tough issues is this: Jesus is both like us and unlike us. Now, that's a little different than the way some folks have heard it, frankly, but it's vital that we understand that, yes, Jesus is like us and that he faces what we call external temptations of every kind. The temptations we were talking about just a few minutes ago are all before Jesus externally in the known world. You see this, of course, preeminently in Matthew 4, 1 through 11, where Satan does nothing less than tempt Jesus with power, glory, kingdoms, wealth, bread, anything Jesus can want, Satan is offering to Jesus. Jesus, however, never has internal temptation. In other words, in a James 1, 13 to 15 sense, Jesus never has any internal desire in his own heart lure and entice him, to use the language of James in that crucial passage. That never happens for him. That happens for us, for the three of us, and for everybody watching this right now and by recording later, regularly, sadly, even as believers. We still lure and entice ourselves away from what is righteous and godly and holy. That never happened for Jesus. So Jesus never had pedophilic desire come from within him. Jesus never had a desire for bestiality well up from within him. Jesus never had same-sex attraction come from within him. Jesus never had what we call heterosexual lust well up in his heart. He had none of these things. And here we're diving into more directly Christological matters, but I'll say a quick corollary. Jesus was impeccable. Theologians of the Reformed and conservative tradition used to talk a lot more about impeccability than they do. Some still do, but it used to be really the mainline view. In other words, that it was impossible for Jesus to sin. Not just that he didn't sin. Impeccability means that he could not sin. That was the mainstream view among most Reformed theologians, conservative Protestant theologians. We've lost that to some degree in the 20th and 21st centuries. We believe and we write that Jesus was impeccable. And that means, lastly, that he experienced far more temptation power than we ever will, because he felt the full force of temptation, as Denny Burke and Heath Lambert have pointed out, following Charles Hodge, and never yielded to it. Herman Bovink as well, never yielded to it. He had the wave crash over him to an even greater degree than you and I do, and yet he never yielded. What a Christ we follow.